Good evening. My name is Kacper Paradowski and you are watching Poland Daily News. September 1st, the historical beginning of the new school year in Poland, is in a week's time. Today, head of the Ministry of Education, Dariusz Piątkowski, presented guidelines for schools in order to fight the coronavirus epidemic. In the overwhelming majority of schools, classes will be conducted face-to-face. However, schools will have the possibility to switch to online teaching, depending on how the situation develops.
In the established yellow and red zones, the school principals will have the possibility to decide between different modes of education in accordance with the local health department authorities. The details of the various modes are described in the ministry documents with step-by-step instructions on how to carry them out effectively. Our decisions are not made in any exceptional way. They are based on the experiences across Europe and the world. The reports published by the European Public Health Association and the World Health Association point out that children do not pass the disease on easily, and according to these reports, an overwhelming number of European countries have decided to introduce arrangements similar to those in Poland. A dozen days ago, a large part of European countries were unsure as to what decision to make and what approach to take. Today, we see that the majority of Europe has introduced the same conditions for the upcoming academic year as Poland.
Minister of Education Dariusz Piątkowski stressed that the dismissal of Grzegorz Wojciechowski from the position of the curator of education for Łódź had no connection to his statements criticizing the LGBT ideology. However, not everyone is sold on these explanations. Minister of Justice Zbigniew Ziobro, commenting on the curator's dismissal, stated that his case may discourage other curators from opposing LGBT influences in public schools.
Grzegorz Wojciechowski was dismissed from the position of the curator of education in Łódź last week. The decision of the ministry coincided with the former curator's statements criticizing the LGBT ideology. The accusation regarding the work of Mr. Curator appeared several months ago. These accusations did not regard his attitude towards the LGBT ideology, nor his statements made for Trwam TV. The province governor filed the motion to dismiss on August 14th. On the 20th, the decision came back, and what happened next was partly manipulated facts and an unfortunate coincidence of dates. The dismissed curator does not agree with this version of events. First, they dismissed me. Now they search for excuses. They were formulated so generally that you could say that about any curator. In terms of employees leave in every curator's office, in others even more than in mine. I had many thanks from the parents. There were no complaints about me neglecting my duties. When it comes to cooperation with the local governments, I could complain about several local governments which closed schools when I did not agree to that. According to Jakub Jałowiczor, columnist for Gość Niedzielny Weekly, the way the Łódź curator was dismissed was unfortunate at the least. The Łódź province governor gave a rather long list of reasons against the curator, but I wonder why this dismissal came right after his statements, right after the liberals demanded his dismissal. If the reasons were indeed different, then this matter couldn't have been handled more awkwardly. The curator's dismissal came right before the beginning of the school year. As we found out, at this point there is no one person responsible for making important decisions.
Today in the Silesian Voivodeship, Polish Prime Minister Mateusz Morawiecki held consultations on the economic transformation of this region. According to the head of the government, after the implementation of the transformation, Silesia will become the economic heart of Poland.
Wszystkie poszczególne projekty.
The goal of every single project included in the economic plan for the Silesian Voivodeship is to protect workplaces, create new ones, and transform this region so it would attract people who moved out to the other regions of Poland or abroad to another country. We want these people to come back here. We want Silesia to become the heart of the Polish economy. This is our commitment to this region. This is our plan for this region. Today we are talking about almost 60 billion zloty allocated to the program for Silesia, including 20 billion which have already been spent.
The German doctors who are taking care of the Russian oppositionist Alexei Navalny at the Berlin clinic diagnosed him as having been poisoned. Any connection between the Kremlin and Navalny's attempted poisoning was denied today by President Putin's spokesman Dmitry Peskov. The Russian oppositionist was transferred to Berlin last Saturday in an emergency plane. His condition is still considered to be critical but stable.
Oppositionist, blogger and advocate of the fight against corruption, Alexei Navalny fell sick on August 20th on a plane flying from Tomsk in Siberia to Moscow. The machine landed in Omsk under emergency protocol, from where Navalny was taken to the intensive care unit of the local hospital. The oppositionist's collaborators claimed that he had been poisoned. Kira Yarmish, Navalny's spokeswoman, informed on Twitter that he drank tea in the airport cafe before boarding the plane. Navalny spent almost 2 days in the hospital in Omsk. Later, at the request of his family, he was transported to the Claret Clinic in Berlin. The doctors there reported that he was still in a coma state in the intensive care unit. On Monday, it was informed that Navalny's tests showed that he had been poisoned with a toxic substance from a group called cholinesterase inhibitors. Doctors in Germany and Russia differ in their opinions on the case of Alexei Navalny. Unlike the Berlin clinic, doctors from Omsk found no traces of the toxic substances.
Demonstrations against President Lukashenko's regime continue in Belarusian cities. Today, the European Parliament Committee on Foreign Affairs supported the proposal of sanctions against those responsible for violence and electoral fraud in Belarus. The speech to the MEPs via video link was delivered by the leader of the Belarusian opposition, Svetlana Tsikhanouskaya.
In order to facilitate the transitional period, I have initiated a National Coordination Council composed of all layers of the Belarusian civic society and all sides of the political spectrum. Unfortunately, the authorities responded with threats and intimidation against the members of the council, including Nobel Prize winner Svetlana Alexeyevich. The intimidation will not work. We will not relent. We demand our basic rights be respected. We demand all political prisoners freed. We demand to stop the violence and intimidation by the authorities. Belarusian people deserve better. Europe deserves better. Thank you.
We will not relent.
Today in Vilnius, former president of Lithuania, Valdas Adamkus, received the Lech Kaczyński Prometheus Award. The award, which was presented by the former head of Polish diplomacy, member of European Parliament Anna Fotyga, is awarded by the Niezalezna.pl portal. Valdas Adamkus was the president of Lithuania in 1998-2003 and 2004-2009. He was a friend of the late president Lech Kaczyński, with whom they traveled to Tbilisi during the Russian invasion of Georgia in August 2008. That's all for tonight. Thank you for watching. Stay with us for Poland Daily Business. Good night.